So this is a story about two icons, and it's a kind of an urban legend a little bit, but now you guys are bringing it back. What made you want to retell this story?
I was just obsessed with it. I moved to LA right around the time, like really right around the time Biggie was shot, and I have been obsessed with it ever since. Obviously, very different backgrounds, but he was my generation, and I was caught up in all that stuff, just reading about it, music, loving it all. And for years, I've just been obsessed with it. And one day, I just said, I'm gonna write this thing and see what happens. Nothing else to get it out of my system.
Yeah.
And just happened that they made it, and then it became the real job. It became about the amazing collaboration with Mark and Andy Hemingway, with all these tremendous writers, all the people that knew these guys, and not just the artists, also the police. It's been fantastic.
Yeah. I think people are also going to learn that there was so much more to them than what they knew through the media at the time. They were so much more prolific as artists. They were so much more interesting as human beings, and they were so much more like all of us than I think most people realize.
Yeah. I wanted to, going into my second question, what do you think we're going to learn about the icons that we didn't know before? Because I feel like we all kind of were there watching it, and we've heard the story so many times, but what are we going to learn from the show that we didn't know before?
That they were young men.
Yes.
That they were on the rise. That they had not accomplished everything they could have accomplished in their lives, and that they had families, they had parents, they had loved ones like everyone else who mourned their loss as much as any of us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I mean, there are key events that have been covered in movies and have kind of been, and we cover those things, but there's a lot of just human moments, just approaching them as not icons in a way that makes sense. Just as young men dealing with tremendous fame all of a sudden. I don't know how anyone would deal with that. So the whole thing was like not to judge them, to really just kind of, you should tell this very human story.
Okay.
Yeah.
And so with there being so many speculations about what everyone else thinks happened, what type of research went into this?
Oh, tons.
It's been a chapter of my life, put it that way. And I think I know too much at this point. It keeps me up at night. A lot. We talked to so many people who, and not just police officers, we talked to guys from Death Row, talked to gang members, and it's been a fascinating experience. So we talked to everybody. And everybody has it's been fascinating to hear different takes on things. Yeah.
As well as people who knew and worked with them as musicians.
Yeah. Because I was going to say, what do you think is the biggest misconception that people have about Biggie and Tupac?
That's a good question. I guess the obvious one is that they hated each other. It was more complicated than that. And they started out as friends. And they probably would have, unfortunately, I feel like if things had just gone on a little bit, they would have got over this. It was just kind of this insane, that's what I always come back to. It was an insane period in American culture with the East Coast West Coast war. I mean, now there's Twitter beefs, right? It's a whole different different ballgame then, and it's insanity. And that and you look back at it and you're just like, how did this happen? And we were all kind of a part of it. They were selling records. There was money in it. It's a real shame.
And then last question, favorite line from Biggie and Tupac. Well, favorite. We'll do favorite song from Biggie.
Oh man, that's a tough one. I like Everyday Struggle, and then for Tupac, I like Life Goes On. I just like the optimism of it.
I like Dear Mother, and I love Party and Bullshit. I love a song that just says let's have fun.
Absolutely. Well, thank you guys, and so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.